And now we're going to talk about your responsibilities as a school bus driver. Of course, it would include safely transporting your students, having your driving under control, and having your attitude under control as well. Responsibilities as a driver. Let's talk about it. First of all, a high standard of conduct. How you carry yourself, how you behave in difficult situations or stressful situations. Very important that you have a high standard of behavior when you are driving a school bus. We'll be talking about driver technique and the way to handle a school bus, how to handle your passengers and to take care of special situations with them. Public relations. You will be communicating with a number of individuals as a school bus driver, starting with the students, to the parents, to the school authorities, transportation director, perhaps even to authorities beyond that. You'll be discussing things with your supervisor or contractor and also with fellow bus drivers. And you'll have a relationship to the transportation director that is extremely important. So let's just take a little bit more time. Talk about some of these things in particular. A up there, high standard of conduct. A school bus driver is expected to meet standards of conduct higher than other professional drivers. Your conduct on and off duty must be such that your actions are not open to criticism. Just remember, school bus driver, especially when you're in the school bus, everybody is watching. And your school bus has a number. And your school bus has video and audio if you're driving for Troy Area School District. Your students and their parents place great confidence in you, so you need to be dependable. You need to be emotionally stable, mature enough to cope with unexpected situations. You are to be a role model to other students. Be interested in the welfare of others. You are a representative of the school district. So you must be patient and understanding. You must enjoy working with students. Of course, being observant of traffic laws, regulations, and rules. Be as neat and clean as you can be in your dress as a symbol of the entire school system which you represent. Refrain from loud, obnoxious, or profane language. Now your driving technique has a lot to do with driver attitude. Your attitude toward driving, your knowledge, and your skill are all developed through an interest in safe driving. This development includes pre-employment training and continued in-service training, such as you are having today for those of you who have been a bus driver for perhaps several years. Development of driving technique requires consistent reevaluation and improvement. A safe and defensive school bus driver must handle and maintain control of the bus at all times. But you say, what about the passengers? The conduct of the passengers depends upon the driver. Let me say that again. The conduct of passengers depends upon the driver. You are in the driving seat and you are the boss. You can, in a very firm, kind, yet assertive way, control your passengers on the bus. Try as much as possible to establish positive relationship with your student passengers. To a large extent, passenger behavior will depend on your rapport with them. A way to establish good rapport and show interest is to try to learn your passengers' names and greet them when they enter the bus. This can help you gain their confidence. Also, compliment your passengers' good behavior. Explain the rules of the bus at the beginning of the school year and maintain discipline according to those rules. Communicate with passengers. Be businesslike, yet friendly. Treat everyone the same and be fair in all that you do. Respect co-workers as well. The behavior of school bus drivers can directly influence the opinions people in the community have toward the school district. Sometimes school bus drivers are the only representative of the district that the parents of the students meet. How bus drivers interact with their children will guide the opinions of those parents. Students and their parents have a wide variety of opinions about the school system. Treating everyone with courtesy and professionalism will do much to enhance your reputation, as well as instill confidence in your student passengers and their parents. All safety enforcement officers are part of the same safety team as you are. These include crossing guards, school patrols, state police, local police. Work with them. Their cooperation with you and yours with them enhance the safety of students. Good relations with the community begin with good relations with your coworkers. An organization whose employees demonstrate mutual friendliness, interest, and respect is in a position to extend good relations beyond itself. The school bus drivers should look different than students. Clothing that is more like the clothing worn by students is inappropriate, such as jeans with holes or patches and jackets with inappropriate language limits. This all limits the driver's ability to command the necessary level of respect. Shoes must comply with school district safety standards. Some examples of shoes that may not meet safety standards might include open-toed shoes, sandals, clogs, wooden-soled shoes, shoes with heels more than 2 inches high. The best shoes for driving have a flat sole, cover the entire foot, and fasten securely. Because your supervisor and your coworkers are all members of the safety team, transportation safety for your student passengers depends upon cooperation among all members of the team. Your supervisor is as concerned with the safety of your passengers as you are. The list of ways to cooperate with your supervisor given in the school bus driver district is to listen to the rules, understand the rules, know the rules, and work with the rules. Training manuals can summarize with these actions: communicate, report, comply, and assist. Your transportation director. Consider the transportation director as your advisor and partner. The transportation director is especially helpful to you when you are working through discipline problems on your bus. And now the requirements. Health and safety. Local school district requirements may be more stringent than these. Your employer should be able to offer guidance regarding specific requirements, such as the number of traffic violations on your record that are considered excessive. Also, remaining alcohol-free means not consuming any alcohol within 8 hours of driving a school bus. The federal government has required drug and alcohol testing for school bus drivers since the 1990s. Companies or school districts with 50 or more employees were required to implement testing first, beginning January 1, 1999. Companies or districts with 49 or fewer employees were required to implement testing beginning January 1, 1996. There is pre-employment testing. All applicants must submit to testing at the time of application. There is also random testing. This is a lottery-style selection process. After selection, the names and all the drivers go into a tumbler of some sort, return to a lottery system, and thereby you will become eligible as you are picked from that lottery. There's post-crash testing. It's required for any crash involving a fatality or bodily injury or requiring immediate medical attention away from the scene. And the bus driver has been issued a citation. Or vehicle damage sufficient to require towing, and the bus driver has been issued a citation. PA requires post-accident by state law after all reportable crashes. There is reasonable suspicion testing done when a train supervisor observes specific actions or driving techniques and feels like perhaps it would be a good time for testing. Return to duty testing. This is only conducted if an employer has a second chance policy. In most instances, if you have a drug issue, you are going to be released from duty, never to return, at least not to that school. And then there can be follow-up testing as well, recommended by a substance abuse professional after an assessment following a positive result or refusal to take a test. After return to duty testing, follow-up testing is conducted for a period of 1 to 5 years with a minimum of 6 unannounced tests during the first year. This testing is in addition to regular testing. So the bottom line on this is you just don't want to mess around with drugs or alcohol. Stay clear, stay away, keep your job as a school bus driver. Driver recertification, we're going to be talking about that, the process, your physicals, change of information on your license. Some of this we covered over, we already covered in the first session, so this is just a reiteration, but it's going to deal primarily with those that are already bus drivers, which is a good number of you today, and we'll discuss the particulars. When you successfully complete the training and testing requirements, a new school bus endorsement card will be issued 45 days before the expiration of your current S endorsement. Now, the S endorsement is a yellow card that you get and carry with you, and it's good for 1 year. Has to be renewed every year. If the skills and knowledge examination is failed 3 times, the applicant must surrender their current school bus endorsement card to the examiner. That applicant must then apply for a new learner's permit and redo all the training and examination requirements. When taking the examination for recertification, you will need a valid driver's license, school bus recertification notice, which you will get in the mail up to a year prior, valid physical examination certificate from your doctor that shows you have had your school bus physical, current vehicle registration card for the bus driven during the examination, and valid proof of financial responsibility for the bus driven during the examination. You will be asked to sign a school bus driver training report form, DL-714, and I will ask you to do that today before you leave, for those of you who are getting recertified, to verify that you have met the minimum training requirements. If you have not, do not sign the form. Falsifying this form may be punishable by a fine and imprisonment. Annual school bus physical examination. It recently changed from 12 months to 13 months so that you can keep it the same month every year. So you have a 13-month period now. It has to be done by an approved state-approved health care provider. School bus endorsement card will not be renewed without this physical exam. Change of information on your license will get you a new camera card or photo license. If you add or delete an endorsement, or remove a restriction, or upgrade your class of license. When changing name or address on a CDL or school bus endorsement card, you have to submit form DL-80CD with appropriate fee. If you change your address on just a regular driver's license, there's no fee, but if you're driving it for money, then of course the state's going to get a part of that, and you need to fill out the form DL-80CD. Some of this information we went over rather quickly, so I want to refer you as far as responsibilities and roles of a bus driver to this website. And this can be a very helpful resource in getting answers for any questions you might have. It comes directly from the state of Pennsylvania, and it's a very well done website, and I highly recommend it if you have questions or want to get forms or learn something more about bus driving. All right, very good. Let's do some review of this section. Question number one in our review for the roles and responsibilities of the school bus driver. Unit A in the Pennsylvania School Bus Driver's Manual states that the bus driver should consider what three general items? Roles, responsibilities, and requirements. Responsibilities, requirements, and driving techniques. Routes, regulations, and requirements. Or D, travel times, road conditions, and railroad crossings. Well, Unit A is specific to roles, responsibilities, and requirements of the bus driver that we just went over in this session. Your role as a school bus driver includes all of the following except: you are a member of a safety team, attitude, vacation time, you are important. And of course it is your vacation time. When operating a school bus, the driver is required to carry which of the following? Valid CDL with S&P endorsements, valid school bus endorsement card or your yellow card or S card, valid physical certificate, or all of the above. And you better have all of these if you're going to be driving a school bus. Remaining alcohol-free means not consuming any alcohol within 8 hours of driving a school bus, plus never consuming illegal drugs. Drinking only non-alcoholic beverages the entire school year. None of the above, or keeping your alcohol level under 0.2%. And of course, the appropriate answer is A, not consuming any alcohol within 8 hours of driving a school bus, plus never consuming illegal drugs. School policy, most school policies, but certainly the school policy for Troy Area School District is permanent dismissal if there's drugs in your system. No second chances. Last question in this session. When taking the examination for recertification, you will need what? Valid driver's license and the school bus recertification notice. Valid physical examination certificate. Current vehicle registration card for the bus driven during the examination and proof of financial responsibility for the bus driver during the examination, which is your insurance card. All the above. And of course, when you take your test, if you're going to do your in-bus, especially if you're going to do it with me or with any other examiner for that matter, you need to bring all of these: your license, your physical card, registration, and insurance. And if you want to bring that paper that you got from PennDOT about a year ago, prior to your expiration, then I can sign off on that too. But that paper that you get from PennDOT is for your records only. So you should get it signed off on and then keep it in case somebody says you did not do something that you actually did.